Except the person in there. Like, is he a noun? The answer is, he would be in second place, of course. If the guy running passes the person in second place, he has now overtaken that second place position. Okay, here's a tough one. Michelle was born on December 28th, but her birthday always falls in the summer. How is this possible? Have you figured out the answer yet? If not, don't worry. It took us a while to figure it out, too. The answer is, Michelle lives in the Southern Hemisphere. Places like Australia and New Zealand have their winter during our summer. So for Michelle, even though her birthday is in December, it falls in the summertime.
So you see, why did I share this particular video with you? Just to let you know that what we are dealing with, whom we are dealing with these days is this Z generation, you know. We belong to our generation, and these children, they are living in an info age. They need much more than they already know from all the information that is already floating to them. So it's very important that we give them something that they are looking for. Otherwise, you see, most of the things are available on YouTube. Yes, and on Google. So everything is clearly available to them. Now, just look at this picture. For a fair selection, everybody has to take the same exam. Please climb that tree. So I think you can very well imagine now, monkey, it's fine. But what about the elephant? And what about this poor fish? So how can we test everybody at the same level? That was the question that arose. And you know, that was the main thing that we actually, you know, that made everyone to ponder over, because there was a discrepancy in learning levels. That was what it was found, that there was a discrepancy in learning level. That is why you see there was a national assessment survey that was conducted in 2017, which, you know, came out with the decision that there has to be learning outcome based education. That is why the introduction of learning outcome based approach was thought about by CBSE first in 2018, because, you know, they started working on it right in 2017. It is not something new. And, you know, for secondary level, we got the information last year. Yes. So what did we get? We got the information about alternative academic calendar, which was given by CBSE in the circular on, the number is already given here. It was released on 14th May 2020, which talked about competency-based education, which is actually, you can say, the amalgamation of ability, skill, knowledge, and attitude that helps a child or an individual to perform a task in real life. So that's what was focused on. Now you see, suppose we, in our schools also now, based on this, some activity rooms have been, created, where suppose the small child, if, you know, we want to give the child the practical knowledge, you know, suppose he goes out somewhere to the market, he should know what is he going to purchase, how much is it going to be the cost, where is he going to get the thing, and when he can go and purchase, so all the things. So it's better that, you know, we give them the live experience, the practical experience, rather than just giving them the theory-based education. That's what we have been doing so far. And that is why you see now these days, since last year after COVID-19, you see parents have become our stakeholders, and they have also been helping us in, you know, providing the knowledge that we want to give our students. Earlier, what used to be there, it used to be a class of a group of students of nearly same age, controlled by a teacher, accommodated within specific period of time. And there were main three key aspects: teacher, student, and the subject material matter or the content. And the aim is to enable students acquire knowledge and understanding. But we don't have to limit ourselves to this only. Yes? Now the purpose of CBA is, if you look at the picture, this is deliberately chosen. It starts with a question mark and how gradually, you know, it takes a shape. That's what is important. You see, it is there actually to assess the progress of children. Focus on learning, not only on scores and marks. Because, you know, according to one survey, it has been found last year that only 19% of engineering students could actually get the employment. So it was really, really very thought-provoking. And how it happened, when everything has been going on, the education is given the way it has to be, why our children are not able to, you know, get the employment. So employability was actually very low, and that is why, you know, these kind of questions came to the mind. And then definitely there is the emphasis on development of capacities and competencies. All right, I need to keep admitting the people that are coming in between. And please listen to me, you know, everything very carefully, because after this, I'm going to share a link with you where through which you can get your certificates as well. All right, so let's move on. Now, what are the basic characteristics of competence-based education? First, it defines competencies. I mean, real life-based. It has to be, you know, all the information, the education, that all the activities that we actually prepare that are real life-based. They're based on real life situations. Application-based, oriented, yeah, in real life. So the students can actually practice that. And above all, it is measurable through learning outcomes. And that's what is going to play a very important role. Now, what are all the things that, you know, define the nature of competency? First is the achievability. It refers to skill, knowledge, attitude, and behavior that can be achieved. And then it talks about the measurability, as I told you. And this is defined, hence it can be measured in a particular time, and, you know, based on the learning objectives that we decide after every particular topic for our group of students. And then communicability, understood by everyone concerned, teacher and student. So it's very important that teacher communicates the learning objectives, not only to students, but to parents also, so that everybody is clear what are we going to achieve immediately after we complete a particular topic or some content. And then appropriateness, have different standards or levels depending upon the characteristics of learners. So it's really very important. Now, what pedagogy are we focusing here? It is child-centered. It includes everyone. So this is the most important aspect. It is all inclusive, includes all kinds of children. Then it focuses on collaborative learning, cooperative learning. So we have to think about the activities that focus on enhancing these skills in our students. Then reciprocal teaching, that's also very important. We learn, it is two-way communication. You know, it's not only jug-like teachers, you know, pouring all the information in mug-like students, as we used to follow earlier, you know, times. So now this is reciprocal teaching. So discussion plays a very important role, especially in senior classes. And then comes group projects, peer teaching, blended learning with ICT. So all the important characteristics are there, which are a part of the pedagogy of this particular CBE. Now, I just would like to show you something. Just have a look at it. Would like to show you through this small presentation is the difference between the traditional education that we have been following versus this competency-based education. Now, here there is a shift from covering the syllabus to learning outcomes. Now we must remember that it is not covering the content, but it is uncovering the knowledge, the learning. Yes, now there is a shift from paradigm shift, you can say, from passive learning to student-centric, active learning, experiential learning. That's what I'm going to talk about in a few minutes now. Then from the segmented curriculum, now there is a shift to integrated curriculum, you know, art integration, and we are including all the other, all kind of students there in our, you know, teaching system. So there is a big shift now from just memorizing the facts. Now there's a focus on thoughts, you know, and where we have to remember, focus on understanding, application, analyzing, and creating by students. So we don't have to just stop at only knowledge and understanding, but just going beyond. I'm going to talk about this and also be sharing you one or two examples according to the time. How are we actually giving the opportunities to students to create what they learn? Then from spoon feeding facts to leaving space for independent thinking and critical reasoning. It is very, very important for students. And now from school centrality, that means not confine the information only in school-based teaching, but society centrality, that means hands-on learning, the project that students are going to learn, they're going to do. And you see this online teaching that did not stop teaching studies, you know, it went on. In fact, it helped students, it helped teachers also. I'll show you how it helped in, you know, making your content much more enriched and much more useful for students. Earlier, many teachers were not able to use it during the classes. I'm just going to talk about all this, but just first have a look at it. Now, there is a technology, there is a, you know, education which is now technology-based. Now, it is activity-based. Students have hands on it, do it yourself, they learn through projects, build their self-reliance capabilities. So we are there only as a facilitator. We take a back seat, we are no more a sage on stage, and we want our children to enhance their capabilities, whatever they have, the innate talents, and we are there to support them, to guide them. And then the week-wise plan also, textbook-based week-wise plan, that is also being shared by CBSE. I'll be sharing you the link, and we can also plan it. So while planning our activities, it is very important we take care of all the things. Now the activities and challenges are to be given to students, and most importantly, mapping the theme with learning outcomes. That's what it all based on. It's very important. The objectives are very much clear in our mind as an educator, and we are sharing it with our stakeholders, with our students, with our parents. Now you see, earlier I was talking about experiential learning. Earlier it was only memorizing facts. You see, the information is just poured in into the mind, the brain of students. And now creativity, now doing, experiencing, thinking yourself, and then find out, focusing more on reasoning. According to the, I think we all must be knowing about Cole's experiential learning theory, which is a powerful foundation approach to all forms of learning, development, and change. Experiential learning describes the ideal process of learning, invites you to understand yourself as a learner, and empowers you to take charge of your own learning and development. See, how does it start with abstract conceptualization? As I showed you the picture of a bell, it starts with a question mark, and how does it read? With active experimentation, concrete experience, and finally reflection, observation. Very important. If we talk about in simple words, it moves on from thinking to practice to doing, and finally reflect. So experiential education really plays a very big relevant role here. Now, the retention rate, according to the research, it has been proved. If you look at this pyramid, you see lecture method that most of us used to rely on makes students retain only 5%. It is obsolete. Reading makes students retain only 10%. Only audio vision that we have been relying on as long as we were teaching offline in our schools makes students retain only 20%. This is also out. Demonstrations, only 30%. So now the focus is on last 3 to 2C. Discussions, yes, but not only one way of discussion. I'll be telling you there are different ways of discussion that we can do. Let me just give you one example of carousal discussion. In senior classes, what you can do, just giving you one example for a minute, you can divide the whole class into two groups, can make one group sit in a circle, or maybe, you know, if you are there on online classes, you divide the class in two groups, one group remains silent, observer. The other group, you float a topic, tell them to discuss something and give them just 10 minutes to talk about. And then you make them be quiet for now, next 10 minutes, and all those who are observing, the rest of the students, group two, you invite them to give their feedback. And what they can say, they can tell, okay, was there anyone who was, you know, dominating in the group? Was there anyone who was not taking part in the discussion? Did they deviate from the topic? Were they there in the topic? Develop the topic logically. So these kind of feedbacks can be given by each member of group two. And similarly, the same way, you can now give a chance to group number two, either in the same class or the next class. You can throw the same topic or a different topic, let the discussion go on, and let the other person, let the other group give the feedback. You say, you see, the discussion is the same. The only thing, you change the pattern, children really enjoy it because you bring novelty. Children look for some changes, some novelty in your teaching. Otherwise, they get bored to, you know, the same pattern that we have been adopting. So this way we have carousel learning also, we have fishbowl discussion. There are different ways we can actually talk about it. Then next is practice by doing. So you give children a chance to, you know, practice things on their own so that they have the experiential learning. And then you make them stand in your place. They start teaching the other students, and then only they get the optimum learning, which is also not more than 80 to 90%. They still cannot retain 100%. So we need to think about those activities which actually cater to the needs of all kinds of learners, and we call it multi-sensory learning. I'm going to talk about it in the next slide. Actually, it is very difficult to cover everything in 1 hour session, but I just would like to give you the, you know, I like to touch all the topics so that you get an idea of what I'm actually talking about, and maybe some other time, you know, we can talk about the other things also in detail. So now there's a shift from teacher control to student empowerment by allowing children to choose. Like you see in the picture, I love volunteering at the park. I was just sharing, I had a CBSE workshop also last week, and I was sharing with my teachers. I told them that, you know, very recently we celebrated one Mahotsav, and we had to send the pictures to CBSE, all the things. So a child of grade two, you know, he actually took an initiative. Father was interviewing the child, and child was talking about different trees and different plants, trees and the plants. And mother was making a video, and he sent that video of 2 minutes. See how beautifully children take a step, one step further, and parents also, you know, help, and then they send it. So we really liked the video, and I shared it among all the teachers to know and to check, you know, how things are done. And that's how, you know, we give liberty to students to celebrate the way they want. Our main focus, they should learn, and they should have the experiential learning. And that's what children do it very beautifully. Yes? Just talking about implementation of experiential learning, there is a hand on it, which is available at the CBSE academic.mic.insight. You can check it out. Now, what is the purpose of using innovative pedagogy during online classes? First, it is to educate our students effectively. Second, to enhance our students' learning. Third, to support their capabilities, as I told you earlier. And then modify our strategies or styles of instruction. As I told you, we need to bring novelty. We need to bring, use different strategies, different techniques, activities, so that children always find some surprise element, you know, in our teaching, and to meet the needs of various kinds of learners. This is what I was telling you. It's multi-sensory learning, yes, that caters to the needs of kinds of learners. You know, in our class, we have visual learners, we have auditory learners, we have kinesthetic learners, and we have tactile learners. So I'm not going in detail, but I think we all know visual learners learn when you, you know, show them some charts, some pictures. Auditory learners, when they hear things, you know, when somebody, even to the lectures. Kinesthetic learners, when they have a lot of movement, You know, they have, we have movement dictionary, we have some activities, we have they have to go and explore outside, they do experiments. So this kind of thing, these are the kinesthetic learners, and tactile learners are those who learn by doing things with their own hands. Yes. If because students learn in different ways, and we all know that we rely on our senses to receive information from the outside world. Most of the students develop a preferred learning style. I hope you should be knowing about your preferred style. I have a test in which we can actually check our preferred learning style, and when we know it, it becomes easy for us to, you know, learn the same way. So if we want that learning should take place very rapidly and quickly, the information needs to be presented all these four learners in order to all kinds of learners in my class. So when I sit down to plan my activities, you know, to plan my lesson, to include all such activities which actually cater to the needs of my auditory learner also, my visual learners also, my kinesthetic learners also, and my tactile learners also, so that I'm able to reach to my different kinds of learners in a class, and the retention is optimum. That is my purpose. Now, what is the usefulness of this approach? It takes you away from rote memorization. Even our students, what they learn today, it remains with them throughout, so they do not forget it tomorrow. Assessments are continuous and competency based, and directly linked with objectives of learning experiences that they, you know, whatever we experience, all the very pleasant and all the very unpleasant moments and experiences remain with us throughout. You may also, if I ask you, you will also remember about your school days, anything that happened with you that gave you the kickstart, and something that was very unpleasant. So you see, it's always, we always say that students will not remember what did you teach, but they will always remember how did you make them feel while teaching the particular topic. So please make them feel so good so that it remains with them throughout, and your classes, and you become their favorite. Assessment results used for further improvement. Now, what do we do? You know, it has a provision to conduct remedial coaching for low achievers, enrichment programs for high achievers, and learning-friendly activities. I'm going to share a few activities, some samples, so that you get to know, you know, about the role plays, quiz, puzzles, and practice riddles. So all the things can be done. Yes. And obviously, fun-loving and, you know, very interesting activities are to be included in this teaching-learning process. And when we talk about teacher's role, as I told you earlier, the learning objectives, you know, as advanced organizers, and ask students to paraphrase them in order to get complete understanding. So you need to share it with students, with our stakeholders, very clearly, so that they know what we are going to achieve after that. It was also told to us, even if we take offline classes, the first thing we should do is to go and write on the board what are our learning objectives. So what particular objectives are we going to meet in that particular class, the 35 to 40 minutes class, and for the weekly plan that you make. So after the completion of 1 week, what are we going to achieve? And after the completion of the 35 or 40 minutes, what are we going to achieve? And for that, you know, it should be very clear and concise statements of the skills that the students will be able to demonstrate after the instruction is over, so that they should also be able to demonstrate. Second, they should be observable and measurable and clearly understood by our students and parents also. Sometimes what happens in junior classes, because students cannot take all the activities, all the projects, all the research work that we give to them themselves, the parents have to be involved. So it is very important that parents also understand what is to be given. So the instructions that you give along with based on learning objective should be very crystal clear, so that they know what is to be done. And they delineate not only the cognitive achievement, but also the values, life skills, and attitudes students would demonstrate at the end of the unit. That's really very important. Okay, there is a focus on creative and critical thinking practice in our CBE. And you know, these items on reading, mathematics, science, literacy are uploaded on a weekly basis on Diksha app for students for classes 7 to 10. New questions for CCT practice are also uploaded in every Monday and answers are shared on Thursday. So CCT questions and solutions can be accessed through the link that is given here. Yes? That can be checked. You know, CBSC and NCERT is working deeply into all this. Now, if we see, if you talk about the learning objectives, you see it is very much clear. For class 3, if you talk about the language competences, a child should be able to speak with correct pronunciation.
No.
These are the learning objectives I'm talking about. Class 4 student in language competences, after reading the text, he should be able to answer questions like since or because. Class 5 students should be able to read, print and handwriting freely. They should be able to take dictations with punctuation marks. Now, if you talk about the mathematics competencies, class 1 child should be able to count items from 1 to 20 with objects and pictures. Class 4 students should be able to draw angles or different measures with the help of protectors. Class 5 should be able to use unitary method and should be able to find average height from the given data. Similarly, if you talk about the environmental studies competencies for junior classes, class 1 should be able to show courtesy to elders, peers, family and neighbors. Class 3 should be able to identify the list of occupations, produces daily meat articles. Class 4 child should be able to experiment how to purify drinking water. And class 5 should be able to identify physical features of the map and be able to describe them. Very clear learning objectives for junior classes. Now, if we talk about the senior classes, I'll be telling you something about this. But now it is very much clear. Now the learning is not only for testing, it is to learn, and it is learning to learn and teaching to learn. This should happen not only teaching to test and give them grades. Now, assessments. Now, when we talk about the assessments, there are two types of assessment. You know, this comes under criterion reference assessments. CRA, very important, that measure the attainment of learning objectives, or you can say the learning outcomes, which are the essential features of CBE. First is performance assessment, and second is objective assessment. Yes? Now, you can say as the summative and the other one. Okay, now the performance assessment focuses on what learners can do with their knowledge, involving assessments of critical thinking, synthesis, affective and psychomotor skills. Yes? And now you see the subjective one. The assessments have been strengthened because last year, if you remember, we have been told to include 20% case-based questions in grade 10 and 10% in case-based questions in grade 12. Board examination in all subjects. And now if you see, this year we have also got the intimation that the objective type, you know, the percentage has been increased there because now there is a focus on critical reasoning students, because you know these MCQs, either there is zero or one. There is no provision of half mark. So students have to actually think. And you know, when they actually do these questions, they generally get stuck on last two options. So we always tell them that they have to, you know, follow selection by elimination. So two, they're able to eliminate, but the last two options, they find it very similar and they generally get confused. So we need to actually teach them, tell them how they can come to the right answer for that. They need to actually analyze and think. Now, how does this learning outcomes, you know, they help students? They pave way to self-assessment by students who would learn to compare their achievements against the stated outcomes instead of comparing them with their peers. And it also helps them to internalize the learning outcomes. So this is very important for students because then they are able to internalize, you know, the learning outcomes, whether they are able to achieve or not. And then now you see, according to this MEP 2020, there is a provision of self-assessment. There's a provision of peer assessment along with teacher assessment. So it paves the way to students to actually self-assess themselves. Where have they actually reached? Whether they're able to meet the challenge? Because now it is very clear the competition is between child's past to the child's present and child's future goals. It is never the competition between two children. So, you know, all the anxiety that children used to have before earlier during examination, especially board examination, and all the other things are actually out now. So, there will be this tension and this stress and this anxiety will be released a little with this approach. And so, in simple words, students generalize their learning. They integrate it with other areas of their lives outside school. They learn concepts in a more focused and meaningful way. Okay, how does it help teachers now? It's not only students, but teachers are also helped. See, they're able to reflect on the curriculum. Context of learning, they know the context of learning in which they are teaching. Content is very clear to them. And then application and assessment to be designed for ensuring the achievement of desirable degree of learning outcomes. So they always are very much clear what is the learning outcome, where do I need to reach. So it becomes very easy to design their activities and their lesson plan in such a way so that they're able to meet their learning outcomes. It's very important. You see, when we give some work to our team, what do we do? We you know, fix a date. We give a deadline. So once the deadline is given, teachers know that they have to complete it within that time, and they start pondering in that direction so that they can complete it within the time duration, the stipulated time that's given to them. Similarly, if we give them objectives, it becomes very easy for the teacher also to think in that line and prepare and plan accordingly. Now, what is the methodology? You see, first is the icebreaker, the starter activity like we started today. Then second is to gradually come to the main content as we have come. And last is the reflection. Yes, so it is very important that you keep last 5 minutes or 10 minutes for students to reflect upon, because it is two-way. It is not you only, you know, keep telling. So we'll also be keeping the last 5 minutes or 10 minutes according to the time, you know, available to us to reflect upon. Yes, what is going to be your takeaway? I'm going to ask you all about this. So this is the way, the methodology that we need to follow in every class that we take. I'm not going in detail because otherwise it will be taking a lot of time. But here, I just would like to pay emphasis on some important points which we have been adopting, and I think it's really useful for all of us. Now, these are the best innovative practices that we can use to teach any particular subject in senior classes. My focus is on board classes, grade 10 and grade 12. One is effective classroom interactions. It is really, really very important that you make your online classes now, because I know, we all know that this is the new normal and it is going to stay here for a longer time. So effective classroom interactions are really very important. And for that, pre-testing, in-text questions and post-text questions are very important, just to know whether your students are with you, where are you, and you know, whether they are there. So you know, for this, what do we do? I just give you an idea. We generally keep, even in online classes, we keep AMP box. Now, can you write down in chat box and tell me, what do you understand by AMP box? Quickly, just for 1 minute, let me see whether you are with me or not. I'm just talking to myself. In chat box, if you can just write, what do you understand by AMP box? Any idea, any vague idea that comes to your mind? Anyone? Or you can unmute yourself and can tell me, whatever suits you. Anyone? No. No one? All right, I got one. AMP. It is AMP. Okay, I'll just tell you, it is not AMP. It is AMP. It is active mental participation. So what do? We tell children that in between we'll be asking questions, and anybody who's not able to give the answer, you know, will have, you can decide anything. That doesn't actually humiliate the child, but makes him alert. But this is really very important. So you know what we used to do? Deliberately, we used to pick up the name of any child who's not paying attention in your class, especially the online classes. Now, suppose we are taking it on MS Teams or Zoom or any platform you choose. So we tell them to keep their videos on, and we, you know, actually to make the child alert and aware, we just take the name. So the child really become very conscious that my teacher can pick up my, take my name, and then I, you know, have to cut a sorry figure if I'm not able to give the answer. So children remain alert, and then you can, you know, ask them any in-text questions. So that way you can keep your children along. So effective classroom interactions are really very important. Then come focus on regular practice of reading and writing skill tasks. This is basically for language teachers, you know, but for others also, you know, you can always pay attention on this. Then motivational talks regarding newspaper reading. It is very important for our senior students to keep themselves abreast with the latest information, because, you know, the nation that reads is a nation that leads, you know. So it's very important that we inculcate in the habit in our children to become voracious readers. So in between, before starting a class, or maybe during the class, or after that, you can just ask about the latest news, and you know, can ask some probing question and just see anybody is able to get the answer. So if you keep asking this, you know, students know that it's important that we read the newspaper, because the teacher can ask any question in between. So it is really, really very important that we develop this habit among our students. And then comes preparation of question papers in groups and exchange with other groups of to answer. This technique we generally follow with like 10 and 12 students. We divide them in groups, and each group is given a task to prepare the whole question paper. Because you see, now birds, the pattern of question paper keeps changing every year. This year also we got the intimation that there is more weightage to the textbook questions, which has actually gone to the part A, objective type. So children should know that, because generally what do? They write so much for short answers, and they write nothing for the long answers, because they do not see the word limit, they do not see the marks that are allotted to it, and they do not even see the choices. So they, you know, happen to do those questions that they are not supposed to do, and vice versa. So it's very important if you tell them to prepare the question papers, they know the whole scheme in their mind. That's what we want, especially when I talk about English, because these are the subjects, you know, you talk about IP, you talk about physical education, I'm talking about grade 12, you talk about English. These are the subjects that they hardly prepare, you know, outside the classes. So it's very important you give them a practice to make the papers. And in next class, or maybe after two classes, if you exchange those papers to the groups and tell them to solve the question papers in group itself, it not only will be enhancing their cooperative learning, their collaborative learning, their team spirit, but also, you know, they really feel good when they know, okay, these kind of questions were given by this group, and then they are ready to answer, and if they are able to answer all the questions, they really feel elated. So that's what we want. The charm should be there, zeal should be there in students. They should not become passive learners. They know how things are to be done, and our motive is being served, that they are learning, because ultimately they have to take papers also. CBSE is important, you know. Board examination is important for grade 10 and 12. So this technique really works with me, and I've been using it for years. Then class discussions on main topics of prescribed textbooks at length. Children generally, what do? They do not go through the text in NCERT books, and they feel on, you see, the overconfident children, or those who are very bright, they, you know, they refer to different books, and those who are slow learners, those who are help seekers, they do not know how to go about it. So it's very important you tell them during your classes, you pay attention on the text-based information, because even if in the answers in those, if they give textual references, they certainly have an edge over others, and they get better marks. So it's important we train our children to go through the text well. And it's important we give them the simultaneous revision through CBSE papers. It has always been my practice, whenever I complete a particular textbook chapter, I pick up all the questions that have been asked on the particular chapter or the particular lesson in those previous 5 years or 10 years. So what happens? Children get to know which are the oft-repeated questions, which are the oft-repeated topics that are generally asked in the boards. So they are very clear with it, and they prepare those well for the boards, and then they are able to score better marks. And the next important technique is adoption scheme. So what do we practice in our, suppose a particular class, I'm talking about, suppose I talk about grade 12. So all the whole class is divided in five, six students, and that one particular group is adopted by a particular teacher. Because you see, not every child has an affinity with all the teachers. Their wavelength matches with a particular teacher. They get along well with one teacher. So all those who get along well with maybe an IP teacher, or English teacher, or business studies teachers or science, you know, physics teacher or whatever. So that's where we make divide them in groups. And those particular teachers, suppose a particular teacher looks after those, that group of students, you know, very well, even after the classes, she gives them a call at home, she wishes them on their birthday, on their parents' anniversaries, asks them how are they preparing, especially before the boards, and are they facing any problem in particular subject, in a way, giving them the emotional support. In a way, they act as a counselor for them, so that children know that they have somebody to look forward to, and they're always connected to WhatsApp or any other social, you know, the media, so that they are connected even by giving them the calls. Even at night, they are free, students are free to call the teacher, and they know that they can rely on somebody. So that really makes them, you know, peaceful, and they can take the examination well. So this strategy we have been following also for many years. And then personal chats regarding practice and preparation for exams. This slide particularly I wanted to focus on how can we prepare both students for grade 10 and 12 to put them at ease without facing any problem. They can take up the examination. Now, suppose I show you some pictures. You see, we are running short of time. We have 15, 20 minutes, and I want to cover so many things. So I just want to ask you if you can write down in chat box, or you can unmute yourself and tell me what activities can be created with a given picture. Anyone? Yes, Sunita ma'am, what are you saying? Okay, you can write it down in chat box. Storytelling, yes, thank you. Any other? Speech based on the given picture, thank you very much. Role play activity, yes. Character analysis, character description, picture composition, day-to-day activity, thank you very much for your responses. So you see, we can do anything like this. So these are the activities that we can create spontaneously, you know, with students, because our purpose is to enhance their communication skills also, because they are really very important. Now, these are some of the activities which I personally experience, I use. So I just wanted to give you, you know, an exposure to all these things. Press conference we have been using. I'll tell you what is press conference. I'll also be showing you just a glimpse of it. Earlier, you know, we used to use hot seating activity, if you may be knowing. So now in offline online classes, this hot seating was not possible. So I switched it over to press conference. I'll show you how we do it. Then use of graphic organizers. We all must be knowing about it. Text-based drawings, posters can be created. Role play activities are very common. Character analysis, because you see in language, character analysis, there is a long question based on character analysis. So that is also very important. Then summary, synthesis tombstones can be created by students. Adding voice over an animation. This was very popular last year with teachers because they wanted to bring some novelty. So they added the animation, you know, their own voice to the animated animation that they picked up related to the particular topic they want to teach. Domino card activity, I'll be explaining you this also. And number of activities on comprehension or inferring the particular topic as well. Now, these are some of the effective steps to conduct online classes. We need to master technology, maintain adequate work environment, very important. You have to have a particular workstation so that, you know, you can also emphasize on children to have the proper study station. They should not be eating, they should not be sitting on couch, and they should not be drinking something while taking your classes, because generally we observe when they keep their videos on. So all these things, you need to maintain some decorum, some discipline when you are taking the online classes. Communicate regularly with students, you know, it's very important. Keep students motivated and respect their individuality. The moment we shut them during a class, and I'm sure they're not going to open up in your class ever in future. So this is very important. We maintain the dignity of our students, plan our classes well in advance, stimulate discussions, use activity-based teaching methodology, and I'll be showing you some examples of this as well. Now, this is the hot seating activity, as I was just telling you. And in this, what do we do? It's a language class activity. A particular chapter where a child is given the role of a character. The child is, if you know, in grade 11, Ranga's marriage is a topic. So I gave this child the role of Ranga, and there is one moderator. and different students have been told to ask their questions. Yes, and the child who's sitting on hot seat, he has to give the answer, and moderator, the questions are put up to moderator who gives, who puts up the questions to the child.
We all have gathered here on a press conference on a very amazing chapter called Ranga's Marriage by Venkatesh Iyengar. And today, guess who has come to attend the press conference and answer all our amazing questions? It's the character from the Ranga's Marriage itself. Everyone, please welcome Ranga in form of Super Gulati. Now, we'll have our first question. The first question is to be asked by Ms. Manshi. Ms. Manshi, you can ask your question.
Hello, Mr. Ranga. I have a very interesting question from you. I want to ask you, why are you against the arranged marriages?
First of all, thanks for having me here. And talking about this question, you know, when we have a relationship to make it successful, you always need to know the other's opinion. And that is why I opted for love marriage, because in that case,
I request you to use your earplugs because I know the voice is little low. I just would like to give you a glimpse of the activity.
Well, than arranged marriage. If you talk about arranged marriage, it's all about just one or two meetings and then the marriage, and then you are in a...
Pali Sethi. Yes, Mishi Pali Sethi. You can ask your question.
I wanted to ask.
So that was a kind of gratitude and respect for Mr. Shyama.
Yes, that we saw from the chapter. He's such an inspiring character. Thank you, Mr. Ranga, for your amazing appearance here at the press conference here. We would really like to thank you for taking out your precious time and come and answer our amazing questions. You are very much. Thank you.
Now you see, by involving students in such activities, the child who is playing the role of Ranga, you know, he has to analyze the character very well in order to answer all sorts of questions that can be put to him spontaneously. Now, if you talk about children, they learn the technique of asking relevant questions. So, questioning technique is also improved in them. And if I talk about the moderator, that child, you see, his own communication skills are enhanced, because, you know, sometimes children have to, you know, become the mic coordinators, you know, otherwise also they need to present, sometimes they have to have the presentations in the class. So this actually enhances this kind of skills among students. So you see, by conducting only one activity, which not only bring the novelty in the class, but enhances all the other, you know, the skill that we want our children to adopt. So it's very important such activities to be taken up, so that children also feel engaged, they also feel good, they feel that there are new activities being engaged and our purpose is being served. So that was the only purpose of showing you this one example. So it's an interesting way of teaching literature in class very effectively. Press conference. Now the other thing I'm going to talk about is graphic organizers. We all must be aware of this. Since our children cannot keep all the points in the mind, so it's important that we give them the technique of mind mapping, yes, so that they can have all the main points in their mind and then they can elaborate all the other points themselves. This Venn diagram, I've been using it very often because this is my, you know, favorite one, where we can write the common things here in the center and the difference. So it can be used to distinguish between two characters and, you know, these kind of activities. For these kind of activities, Venn diagram is really very important. Now here the comparison is given between tomato and apple, you can understand. So both are fruit, both are round in shape, both are smooth skin, and the difference is mentioned here. So this kind of graphic and organizers can be used so that student can learn better. And then this is a role play activity, there's no time. Otherwise I would have showed you the recorded role play, and you won't believe this was all prepared by students before this lockdown, within you can say first half. And second half, they were ready to prepare and to present the role play, you know, collecting all the material that was readily available to them in school. Some other time, I'll show you this. Now, these are some of the activities that are done during online classes of different subjects. Yes, this is art integrated math activities. These are science, These are yoga activities, physical fitness activities. So students have actually been, you know, sent to parks to do some activities during the online classes so that they are not confined only to their seats and in front of the screen. So just to, you know, reduce the screen time, you can say. This is very interesting. I just would like to show you one because we have less time. This is one of the activities that I gave to class 12 students. I gave them the famous speeches of different people, maybe Barack Obama, the victory speech, or Mr. Ratan Tata's speech, and all these things. And then I told students to retell them in their own words and create a video. I already have a video available with me. Just have a look.
Keep exploring, keep dreaming. Keep asking why. Don't settle for what you already know. Never stop believing in the power of your ideas, your imagination, and your hard work to change the world. Hello everyone. Today, I am Isha Khanna, student of class 12A, Lakshmi Academy Public School, Delhi. I'm here to present a brief synopsis of the victory speech delivered by the former United President, that is Barack Obama, when he gratitude towards the natives of America for trusting in him and choosing him as the future leader.
See, I'm not showing you the whole, but the idea behind is child has been given a particular speech. Different children were given, all the children were given of a particular class. They went through their speech, they, you know, tried to retell in their own words, they compressed it, they went through it, they, you know, practiced in front of the mirror. That's how it enhances their fluency and their confidence and the communication skills. And then they actually came in front of the camera, they recorded it for 1 or 2 minutes and they sent it to me as a project. So you see, there's so many skills are inculcated in students. Now the other one I'd like to show, it is very interesting. This is based on the first chapter of grade 11, Portrait of a Lady by Mr. Khushwant Singh. So what did I tell my children? Because Khushwant Singh ji presented a very beautiful portrait of his grandmother in the chapter. So I told all the grade 11 children to actually, you know, record the portrait of one of the grandparents. To actually talk to them, interview them, and tell them the whole life history, the story, you know, in just 2 or 3 minutes. See how beautifully the children have come up. I just would like to show you because just one example I'm showing you because we do not have time to show you all. The children came up very beautifully.
My grandpa is a great man. He's an ocean of knowledge and great source of inspiration for me and my family. In this documentary, I, Saita Arora, would like to introduce my grandpa, Mr. Ramjilal Arora. My dadu was so zestful and exuberant player of his time. He reveals how he, along with his friends, used to play marbles, Coco, Gilli Danda, and Seven Stones. He also used to climb trees, grab all the fruits, and have gala time with his mates. He was also obliged to take care of his younger siblings. He was so responsible and did his duty commendably. He used to take care for their studies, played games, and supported them whenever they needed. He had been living in Ajnara village, UP, and migrated to Delhi in year 1958. He completed his graduation and became a successful employee. He met my grandma in year 1970 and became an optimistic and loving couple. He was a multitasker. Despite his career, he successfully raised 3 children. He nostalgically remembers the days when me and my sister were young. He used to play with us and take us to nearby parks for swings. He also took great care of me and used to bring me back books. And along with that, he is also fond of gardening and reading newspapers. He dedicates it to my grandpa. Grandpa has ears that truly listen, arms that always hold, love that never ends, and a heart that's made of gold. Love you, Dadu.
So you see how beautifully children actually, you know, they met their grandparents. If they're not staying with them, they went there, they collected their photographs, they had an interview of them, and then they, you know, came up with beautiful videos for only 2 to 3 minutes and they sent it. I must tell you the kind of videos that they prepared. I wanted to show you all that, you know, just as a sample, I showed you one, how can they actually do it. So you see, these are just the novel ways that we can actually adopt to take our children to create things. Because I told you initially that we have to bring to such a level where they analyze and then they are able to create things on their own. And this is the best example of that. Yes, now this is something that I talked about, adding voice over an animation. Teachers last year, they actually, you know, used it very well because they used it, the apps like TwinCraft, where you can record the voice simultaneously along with the animation. But the thing is, it is auto-modulated. Some people are not able to cope up with this. So what they can do, you can also try. You can use an app that is called AnyMaker, which comes with a dialer. And then InShot app is there, which is there to actually insert voice. So afterwards, the voice can be inserted. This is also very popular among teachers. And students really enjoy when they see, rather than only seeing PPT every time, you know, you show and you teach, you can use this, you know, adding voice over an animation. That is a real change for students. So this can be done. I also have a copy of this, but I'm not going to show you because it's time. So can I take 5 or 10 more minutes and can wind up, or you want it to finish now? It's up to you.
Ma'am, you may take. You should
get
more time.
We are here with you. There's so much to share, but you see, time constraint.
Please do, ma'am. Please.
Yeah.
Ma'am has got so please much of information. Ma'am. Time is falling
short. Very nice session. Please continue.
Continue, ma'am, please.
Shall I continue for 10 more minutes?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Sure.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. So now, this is what I was just telling about domino card activity. This is really, really very interesting activity, which can be used for, you know, new words and their meanings, question answers, idioms. What we can do in this, I'll just explain you briefly. We can take a, you know, card like visiting card like cards, and on one side we can write down different words. You can use it for, you can say, you know, some short terms for which you want the meanings or some explanations. So one side we can write down the terms or the new words or some short questions or idiom, and the flip side of it, we can write down the meaning or the answer of some other word. So what we can do is we can distribute these cards among different classes. If you have less words, you can give it to a pair, and if you really have less ones, then you can give it to different groups of 3 children or 4 children according to the class strength you have. And then you know, you can ask one child or one group if they have the word, and anybody who's got the answer of that particular word, he thinks or he assumes that he has the answer. He raises the hand, he tells the answer. If the answer is correct, everybody says thumbs up. I'm talking about grade 11 and 12. You see, these kind of children also enjoy, because earlier teachers used to tell me, ma'am, these kind of activities are not enjoyed by, you know, senior children. They do not understand that way. But I practiced it myself, and I even, you know, created a video to show to these teachers. The students really enjoy. They really get exuberant when these kind of activities are conducted. Otherwise, you see, if you just have a session on the new words and new expressions, they really get bored, you know, because now there's no blackboard, there's nothing. How can they come to the board and can write down and do this kind of activity? So domino card activity really play a very important role there. Children really enjoy. And if they give a wrong answer, thumbs down, and then the same child gives the word. So that's how it goes on. At the end, every word gets the answer, every word gets the meaning, and that's how the activity gets completed. I intentionally, you know, recorded this particular activity during the unlock time when we had in January, February, because many teachers requested me that. I just recorded it, but somehow I'm not able to rotate it. I'm just going to play it for a minute for you to get an idea how it is to be if you can see.
Hello, students. So good morning to everyone. Today, as you know, we have just completed the chapter Mother's Day, and for your request, we are going to play one game, that is domino card activity, which I know you all enjoy very much. So let's get started with the game without wasting much time. I hope you all know how to play the game. Yes or no? Okay, so let's start with the first. Just a minute. Yes. speak in a low tone. In a low tone. Yes, yes, you're right. Speak in a low tone. Yes, everyone. Okay, the word is bewildered. Yes. Okay, the meaning is confused. Oh, very good. Okay, okay. Now you can read the word that is there.
Grimly.
Huh?
Grimly.
Grimly. Okay, the word is grimly. Yes.
Offensively.
Grimly. Offensively. Do you think the word meaning is correct?
No.
No. Anyone who's got the meaning of the word grimly? Yes. Yes, Imanchi.
Seriously.
Yes, seriously is correct. Yay.
So you see, this was grade 11 and they also enjoyed it because, you know, this activity doesn't take more than 10 to 15 minutes if you have your cards ready. So you need to just go, distribute the cards and then go on with the activity and your purpose is solved, because now in language classes, every time we think that whenever we complete a particular chapter, we at least give them a vocabulary of 10 to 15 new words so that it gets to the permanent memory, and that is possible only when you revise this. So suppose one day we have done a particular chapter, we have used those words, and next day you play this activity as a recap activity just for 10 minutes before you start on with the question answer sessions. So it is scientifically proven that if something is particularly something is revised within 24 hours, then within 1 week, then within 1 month and 3 months, it gets to child's permanent memory. Then even if the child wants, he cannot forget it throughout his life. So that's what is the purpose. When they have the good vocabulary, when they have a good command over language, when they know the grammar well, they will be able to speak, you know, without any hindrance, and then they go on fluently. And that's what I think is the aim of language teachers. So these are the activities, because my subject is English, so I've included those activities which I actually, you know, use in my classes. These are some of the examples. I'm not going to play it for you. I'm just going to tell you. This is a group activity. As I told you, we need to include such activities where we can involve children. So this activity is called jigsaw learning activity, where we divide the whole chapter in 5-6 groups. Each group is given the topic, one particular topic that's divided. So once all the groups make the presentation, the chapter gets over, the teacher is able to give voice to, rest to her voice, and children learn so well. Now, one question that can come to your mind, ma'am, how can we make all the other children pay attention while one group is making a presentation? This is very important, because generally what do we see? Either the children, those who have to make presentation, they keep preparing at that time, and those who are through with the presentation, they do not pay heed. So I just tell them personally that you need to, you know, interject in between. So after the presentation of one group is over, you need to ask questions or you need to give feedback. So once they have to do it, and you keep some marks for this. So they pay attention to such an extent because they know that they're going to get marks for this. So they pay attention, the class is controlled and they are in discipline. They enjoy all the sessions, they learn better, and then you can always give some marks for the feedback that they provide. So this makes learning happen better. And this is also another example of one girl who had a stammering problem. She was not interested in making the presentations, but I gave her so many opportunities that now this is a particular activity where she took the major role. She presented the major part. That is why I just wanted to show it to you. But now there's no time, so I'm not showing. Now, so this is the example of pair activity or group activity. Now, this we recorded for students. This is a TV or radio show where, you know, we recorded it for children to show it to them. How can they present a radio show? Some groups can be given, like, you know, where we are showing them that they can invite a particular person, some celebrity, to the there, and then one teacher or one child can interview the person and other students can ask the questions. Some groups can be given to prepare the commercials in between, like, you know, they see Coffee with Karan, or they can invite any Bollywood celebrity or some famous news reader or anybody, any particular person, and then, you know, can have this activity. I'm not showing you all. This is the individual activity that can be recorded and students can make the presentation. This is a super effective technique, which is a jam session, just a minute round. You may be knowing, whenever children are not in mood to study, you can have, like, for language teachers, we can have just a minute round. I just conducted it once. And I told them, okay, you speak on any hobby of yours or any particular book you like, any sport or anything that's available in the class. One day I conducted and told them, okay, you speak about tube light spontaneously without a break for 1 minute without repeating any particular sentence. Because my motive was to, you know, check their innovative ideas that they get and their spontaneity, their fluency, their language skill. So, you know, that is a very good activity because my motive is to make them learn through action, through doing, through experience, through discovery, through exploration. Yes, because we also prepare them for all these things. So it's important you can have these activities as well. So let me not take much time and let me just come to the conclusion. Okay, these are some more activities. I'm not going to explain them. You can just read it from the text. So these are all the activities that can also be done to give them the experience. Art integration is something that NEP 2020 is all about last year. This is one of the examples that one of my friends did to integrate, because last time the topic was Sikkim. Took one poem and told them to compare it with two poets of Sikkim and then, you know, write down their analysis. These are some of the charts, some posters that I got made by teaching the poems last year. And this I got this year. Very beautifully they came up with integrating it with arts. They have written the themes of all the poems of grade 12 that they did in grade 12. These are glimpses of students' presentation which they prepared last year. I'm not going to show you. How to make the topics intelligible. Please read it once. Not going to talk about it in detail. We have almost covered all these points. We as teachers need to work on all that we have discussed. Please have a look at it and just read it quickly. Already discussed about it. So finally, coming to an end, I just would like to say that we have to take a step of effort that will lead towards the door of success, leaving a huge smile on our faces. Because you see, every time we end our class, we come to know how effective were we, whether we are able to meet our learning objectives or not. Because now, I just would like to say one thing, that we need to aspire not to be the best in the group, but to be the best for the group, so that we can take everybody along and can reach to what we want for our students. Just have a look at it. Thank you very much. See, how can you enable your students? It really gives you satisfaction and contentment of soul. Yes, you have done something for your students.
क्यों मिलता फिर
मिलता
with this, I just would like to tell you that we need to actually prepare our students to be self-independent, enhance their own capacities and capabilities and competences, and we be by their side to give them the emotional support and not limit ourselves to the skies when there is a whole galaxy out there. Keep exploring, keep teaching, keep becoming the favorite of your students, and let them be their own light. That's what is the lesson I just would like to give you. Thank you very much for being patient listeners and be with me throughout. Now I just would like to ask you, what is your takeaway from this presentation before I actually share the link which you can fill and then can get the certificate? Yes. If somebody can share, unmute yourself and can share.
May I, ma'am?
Yes, please.
Ma'am, today I'm actually a computer teacher, but by taking this session, I have gotten that so many activities, even I can put it in my subject. And it's a wonderful session you have given. I just liked your enthusiasm and the way of expressions. Everything was so good. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much. Anybody else who can actually tell me what is...
As a science teacher, now I have got up a plan that even the parts of the diagrams can be made into a card, and what is the function we can make. This is a card one, dominoes was very interactive. With that, each and every part can be made a study to the children and its function.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else?
Literature activities are excellent.
Huh. Thank you very
much. I myself is also language teacher. Whatever your activities you have taken with Ranga's marriage, really I like that. The Portrait of the Lady by Mr. Khushwant Singh, they are excellent, excellent. Because many good takeaways are, yeah, it's there. Thank you very much.
That we need to, give them the variety, because students say no, otherwise you see, we have to cut a sorry figure, they know much more.
Yeah.
Sheer numbers, yes. And then we really feel like being a teacher after getting so much experience, we're still not able to give them what do they want. Because now we have to gear ourselves so that we come to the level of the analogies of our students. It is really very high these days, you see, and they can befool you within a minute. So it's better we have an edge over them and give them something which they actually want. Yes.
Yeah.
That's really
even the speech part also, it was excellent. When famous speeches you have given, I'm going to adopt all these things in my classes also. That was again excellent idea.
See, we actually underestimate the capacities of our children.
Yeah. I got it.
Yeah, and they come up with such beautiful things, I just can't tell you. Acha, okay. Is everybody able to see the link?
Good evening, ma'am. Sunita from Pune.
Yeah.
Your presentation is so good and so knowledgeable, so informative. So, ma'am, excellent. You took too much efforts for this session. It's very good, ma'am. Very good. I like it. And I am going to apply your formulas in my lectures. I am accountancy teacher. So, it's very good, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Ma'am, good evening.
Yes.
Ma'am, good evening. I'm Vanita from Tamil Nadu. Ma'am, I too am an English teacher for class 11 and 12. And it's my first year. Ma'am, actually, I learned so much from you, all the activities. And I think I have to incorporate them in my class. Ma'am, just one doubt. How do you go about your grammar classes, ma'am? How do you really inculcate this knowledge of grammar? Because I find it difficult. Every year they forget what we teach them in grammar,
You see, grammar is to be integrated now. Because you see, in grade 11 and 9, very less portion is given to grammar. Because by the time they come to grade 10 and 12, especially 12, we expect students to, have a hands-on grammar. So it is not important you give them the rules, because they're not going to remember it. So you take it simultaneously, integrate it in your lessons while you're taking the textbook lessons or you're taking any other thing. Whenever you pick up something, you see, whenever you talk about something, you tell students, better it is to be done like this. And why are we using? This is the way. And then you give them some more examples of the same. You ask students the same thing. So what happens? By this, they learn it informally. the language family. You have to integrate it. You cannot, and in between sometimes, you know, whenever they are free, you give them reordering jumbled words, you know, give them one worksheet that's available. Now it is available in the MCQ forms. If you Google search it, number of things are available. So last 5 or 10 minutes left in a class, you are free, you just pick up any sheet, you share it with them and tell them to do it. So the more they practice, you know, in the class, the more they feel confident about using it. So now it is not the time. Our time we used to use Ren and Martin, and we used to keep following the rules and rectify them. But now there is no time of cramming. It has to be integrated, and you need to teach it, you know, while taking your other topics, not to take it separately. This is okay. My suggestion, and that's how I also do it. So now I think the link is available to you. Yeah, please. Yeah, you can fill it so that you can get the certificates. Any other question, any other takeaway before we end the session?
All right. Good evening, ma'am.
Yeah, good evening.
I am Srividya.
Yeah, hello.
I'm Srividya, attending the session from Oman.
Okay, thank you.
It was really wonderful session with lot of takeaways. We cannot mention with one or two like that. So it was a wonderful session, lot of activities. Of course, I am teaching middle section, but it is valid for, I can incorporate this or I can customize this for my classes.
Thank you, ma'am. Actually, I try to incorporate everything for all levels. Otherwise, if our focus is only on senior classes, then the other teachers, they may not be able to get benefit. And when you are spending your quality time 1 hour, I wanted to actually make it very valuable for all of you so that you can get something from it. You see, we all are sailing in the same boat. So we all are learning from each other. In case you have something else you have been using in your classes, you're most welcome to share. You know, we retake, we learn from it, and that's we fail through. Because the purpose is, you know, the target is the only thing we need to just follow what NCRT is guiding us, and then that is actually for the benefit of our students. The only thing we need to just come out a little from our comfort zone, but you see, ultimately it's going to really pay off. Our students are really going to miss your classes. I tell you, I've always been focusing on this, not only just because the CBSE is introduced now, even before that also, and you won't believe my alumni. Even, you know, 10 years back, 12 years back, we are still in touch. We have a great bond, and they always remember me because of all the activities that they've been involved, the opportunities that I've been given to them to take part in classes, and that's what made them, you know, where they are today. So they share that, and that is a real reward of any teacher. Otherwise, we are at the same place. You see, our students have occupied such great places. We are still the same, but it gives you the contentment of soul. Yes, you could do something. So we have the future of our children in our hand, and I just would like to say with folded hands that let's do justice to what we have, you know, so that we can, feel good and great about it.
Bhamna ma'am, one request. Would you please be able to share the recording of this session with us?
I think I will do, because I've recorded. Yes, I'll do that.
Please do that.
In the group, yeah.
Okay, whenever we have the, you know, nostalgic moments, we can always enjoy it again.
Okay,
thank you.
Otherwise, I'll put it on my YouTube channel. You can just see it from there. Yes?
Sure, we'll do that. Okay. No. YouTube channel is with this name only, Bhamna Arora, ma'am?
Bhamna Arora, yes.
Okay, thank you, we'll do it. Okay, thank you.
Okay, so thank you very much. You've already taken so much time of yours. Thank you for being a part of it. See you some other time. I'm going to end the meeting. Have a lovely evening and a wonderful day ahead. Thank you.
Ma'am, sorry to trouble you. I didn't get the link, ma'am. In between, the last 5 minutes, my mobile got switched off. So can you send it once again?
Okay. I'll just share it once again. Just a minute.
Thank you, ma'am.
Just going to share it here for you.
Yes, ma'am.
Sure, I didn't got it now.
Yes.
Please fill it. All right. Okay. Thank you. Bye bye.
Ma'am. Bye bye. Take care.
Bye. Thank you. Bye bye.